Hello and welcome back to another video. So in this video, I'm going to be incorporating ControlNet into a workflow on ComfyUI that already has Animate Diff. So if you checked out this channel the other day, I had a short video on how to basically make short form videos just using textual prompts. It's the text to vid. I'll link to it in the info card or in the description. But right after that video was made, the folks at Animate Diff Evolved or whoever's maintaining that repository did a massive update that incorporated all these brand new Gen 2 nodes. So just to zoom in this workflow is going to be in the description as well, so you can just download it and start playing with it. But as you can see, we are now using separate nodes. It was before just a couple. We're going to be using a zoom in LoRa of 0.2. We're going to be using the version 3 Stable Diffusion 1.5 motion module. And then basically we're just going to be passing our model into here, applying all these, and then passing it into the case sampler. Okay, so just to get you up to speed. So now let's go ahead and get ControlNet loaded into here. So I'm gonna go ahead and load a video that I recorded earlier. So here is a video of me just simply waving. And so I did this because I wanted to see how well it could do hands. And I'm going to only output every fifth frame because doing every single frame will be a little compute intense there. So I'm gonna go ahead and pass this to two control nets. I'm gonna do canny and DW pose. So let's go ahead and get the canny one set. So canny edge processor kind of gets the outline of the subject within the video. So to give you an idea of what that looks like, let's go ahead and just generate a preview. So I'm gonna go ahead and cue the prompt, and we can see, well, we can't really see, but just a sec here. Let me zoom in. As you can see, it does a good job of getting like the outlines of the hand and also the subject. So we will hopefully be able to tell the model what hands actually look like in this control net a little bit better than if it was just to render them. So that is what we're going to use for part of this. So let me go ahead and load the control net model. And so there's lots of control net models available for Stable Diffusion 1.5. I'll put a link to the Hugging Face repository in the description, but we're just gonna go ahead and use the canny one. And then I'm also going to use the Advanced Control Net node. So I'll also put a link to this in the description that you can add to your ComfyUI interface. So you'll have to have ComfyUI Manager installed on your machine in order to add this. Okay, so now that we have that, and let's make it all nice and uniform there, so it'll look good. I'm gonna go ahead and pass this, basically each of these canny images into the control net along with the control net model. So we have that set up. And so with the positive prompt, we're gonna basically take this positive prompt, instead of passing it into the case sampler directly, it's gonna go through the control net, then to the case sampler. So I'm gonna go ahead and take the negative prompt and connect that there. Okay, cool. So we're gonna go ahead and do this again, but this time I'm gonna take in DW pose. So let's go ahead and do that. So let's go ahead and connect these really quick. Actually, I didn't mean to do that one. So DW pose estimator, and then move this up. All right, and then go ahead and create that. So let's go ahead and just run that really quick. And then, whoops, I'm sorry. So the control or the image will go to the control net. And so here is the DW pose. So as you can see here, this is now creating like a wireframe of my body, basically, of the key points within it. Such as the hands, face, shoulders, and such, and torso, and we'll pass that to the diffusion model as well, too. So there's lots of open poses available, but DW pose is the best one because it has a good representation of the hands and face expressions here. So in most instances, it's better to use that than any of the open pose models, or pre-processors, rather. Okay, so since we're using two control nets, we're just gonna basically chain these together And then once they pass through both of these, we're going to go ahead and pass them into the K sampler. And now since we have two, I've noticed that if you leave the strength on at one for both of these, which is the default value, the output often looks cloudy. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to lower this to like 0.3, or roughly like 30% weight. And then for the DW pose, I'm going to do at a 70% weight. Now you don't need to do exactly to 1 or 100%. You can do that less, and it'll put more emphasis on your prompt if you lower both of these values even more. And you can even change when they come into play, whether it is the start or the end percent. Okay, so we have that. And so now I think we are just about all set to get everything going. So just to give you a really brief overview is we're going to be doing a total of 30 frames. At the 0 frame, it's a man on a beach, and at 15, it's a man in a redwood forest. And then that same fixed value is also informing how many latent images to make in the batch here, and we're keeping our seed value fixed. And then we're going to go ahead and create just preview images just to inform us, and then go ahead and combine everything into a short form video. So let me go ahead and remove this bypass. I turned down the steps just a little bit. If you want a better looking video, you'll increase the steps just like you would whenever generating an image. But for demonstration purposes here, we're just going to keep it at 15 so it processes a little bit quicker. Okay, so let's take a look at the output. But while I'm up here, I'm going to go ahead and take over my video that I used as a reference here. So here is the new video. You can see it does a really good job of getting a lot of the things right. The hands still are a little bit weird. There might be a better model out there that could perhaps tackle this problem, but overall it's not bad. And if I was zoomed out a little bit further, it would almost probably be a lot more indistinguishable. If you ever see a lot of those videos online, whether it's Reddit, Civitai and such, is the models, it's typically a full body. So therefore, those small details like the hands, they can kind of sneak by without being as noticeable. But that's the whole point of this test video, was to, put the hands up there. But it still does, for the most part, we'll get 5 digits for that initial wave and over here, but then it kind of gets a little weird. But again, experimentation with this would kind of help to figure out to get the best results. Other things with this is, of course, obviously the hair is the most noticeable difference here, is that, you could definitely change the prompt. Instead of just saying a man, you can say bald man. Or what you'd want to do too is put a little bit more weight on this canny and a little bit less weight on the DW pose. So it gets, this representation of my head is going to be more accurate, because this obviously doesn't have anything. So it's, the model is free to interpret it however it wants, you change the prompt accordingly. But overall though, it does a really good job, and it was a pretty easy way to kind of incorporating ControlNet into the workflow. So with all that being said, if you want to experiment with this, the workflow again is included in the description. So feel free to download it and play around with it. If you have any questions about it, you can always share your workflow in the comments. If you upload it, I think to like the GitHub Gist or Gist, I can take a look at it there, or any screenshots is fine. And if you like the video, please consider hitting the thumbs up and also subscribing to the channel. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I will see you in the next one. Take care.